need patching up.
Welcome home, Sid.
Give me 50 good boards, 8 span each.
Seeing troops amassing at every border crossing.
Clive, you're back.
I am. And with glad tidings for once.
Well, I'll be. All of our comrades who lost their lives back at Sid's place be smiling down at you right now.
We had a stallus from Lubor saying Drake's fang had fallen. I expect that was your doing as well, was it?
It's a long story.
One for the history books, I'll bet.
Welcome home, Clive.
It's good to be back. You look better.
I feel it. Which means I'm coming on your next little adventure. You're not leaving me behind again.
Wouldn't dream of it. Otto. Any word on the Royalist movements since I've been away?
Shouldn't you be putting your feet up? If you really want to know, go and have a word with Vivian.
Thank you. I will.
Conquering hero returns.
I may have picked up one or two.
Well, the fact that you came straight to me instead of visiting our resident physica suggests that you picked Waludas.
The very same. But whatever plans Kupka was hatching with the Royalists, he took them to his grave. As did his men. Slaughtered by the orcs who'd taken over the Fang. Orcs, Vivian. I've never seen such creatures in Storm before. The Waludas must have ferried them over from Ash, but why? Why work to rescue Kupka only to invade his home, the mother crystal of an allied nation, and let both fall? It makes no sense.
Do you know the tale of the blind men and the Adamantus? One can often be led astray by focusing too closely on individual details. One must instead see the bigger picture. And what bigger picture is there than my map? The Kingdom of Walud claims dominion over all of Ash. It is a nation forged by the bloody conquest of Barnabas Tharm, the dominant of Odin. The Canvarian War of Independence in 849. The Battle of the Twin Realms in 865. The Battle of Belinus Tor in 873. Wheresoever his armies fought, Odin was found where the fighting was fiercest. But of late, the warrior king appears to have laid his sword to rest. Battle rages for control of the crystalline dominion. Yet Tharm sends not a single ship in support of his Dalmechian allies. Meanwhile, the Blight ravages great swathes of Ash. Yet warlike Walud shows not the faintest interest in laying claim to untouched lands. So why go to the trouble of sending an army of orcs into the heart of Drake's Fang, only to make no attempt to claim the Mother Crystal for Walud? It can hardly be for lack of men. Tharm's armies rival any in the Twins. No. We have not seen the last of the Waluda standard. Odin will ride again. It is but a question of when. And on that day, who will be trampled underfoot? In summary, I know not to what end the Royalist betrayed Kupka. I know only that it is part of some broader scheme. A scheme tied to the ambitions of one man.
King Barnabas.
But there is no need to wallow in confusion. If one is to cure a sickness, one must first identify the symptoms. And your Lord Uncle has volunteered to do just that by keeping an eye on the Royalists' movements.
He's really throwing himself into this.
Indeed he is. Which means all that remains for us to do is await his reports. Well, not quite all in your case. The people of the Hideaway must hear the news. Justice has been done. Hugo Kupka is dead. The wounds he left that night are still raw. Especially for those who lived with Sid the longest. Tell them that those wounds might finally begin to heal. Consider it the price of today's instruction.
I've never known you to be sentimental.
What can I say? I am only human. And we are, all of us, sentimental animals at heart.
I suppose we are. Very well. I'll go and spread the word.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Fancy a look at the list, do you? Quick look. Seen enough?
I know what you're going to tell me. Thank you, Clive. Thank you.
Let me know if you find any books worth reading.
Oh, we've hundreds of them in the shelves.
You look just like a princess.
And you look like the princess's sister.
your death standing out here.
I know.
I hear you've been busy making friends, Cid. Your predecessor had the same idea. Why, he even extended the hand of friendship to me. Not once, but twice.
Lovely breeze, isn't it?
Sitting here, eating good bread.
Started reading books.
I knew it was a good idea to have editor study alongside the children. It's really stoked their competitive spirit.
I have done it, Cid. I have learned all the letters. Every one.
Mid hasn't been.
Blackthorn, do you have a moment?
What is it? I'm busy.
I wanted to tell you that Hugo Cooper is dead.
I can't tell you how long I've been waiting to hear those words. This is it then. A new beginning under a new Cid.
I'll try to live up to the name.
Well?
Nothing escapes you, Lady Karen. It's true.
Good. I'm starting to get a crick in my neck. Don't let it go to you. Well, don't just stand there gawping. It'd better all be here. You'll break your back stuffing all that in your satchel. Let's not be greedy now. Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Come on, Clive. I was hoping you'd be back soon.
Clive. Sorry, will it be? Last you a good while.
Mm.
less work, but it'll do. Should last you a good while. You can thank me later. Yeah, that should do you. Not bad, if I do say so myself. I meant to do that then. That it. Clive, have you come seeking the gift?
No. To share mine, actually.
Oh, my.
Look, he's crying. He is the big baby.
And with good reason, children. These are tears of joy. We must offer up a prayer to your parents that the heavens might weep with us. There shall be no lessons today, only thanksgiving and merrymaking. Go, put away your things.
All right. Brilliant.
Finally, a new dawn has broken.
It has.
Thank you, Clive. I cannot wait to share the good news.
Hippocrates. After Kuka fell, Ultima came to me. I need to know what he is. Have you learned anything?
Alas, no. And not for want of trying. I have scoured not even the sort of conspicuous absence that might suggest a concealment of fact. One is almost tempted to conclude that such a creature never existed.
But I saw him. With my own eyes.
I don't doubt that you did. Alas, it seems you are the only one who, to others, he reveals naught. We see only that which he leaves in his wake, like some...
A bringer of death.
But until I do, my investigations shall...
Thank you. Right. Let's see if Otto has anything else for me.
Troops are massing at every border crossing.
You barely sat down since you came home. Vivian got you running errands or something.
Just spreading the word.
So, the professor's got... Ah, but you ain't told everyone. I can think of plenty of friends back at the old hideaway who'd sleep more peacefully for knowing. Not least of all Sid. You should tell him. You're right. Well, when you do, be sure to take Mid with you. She's been going at it hammer and tongs down in that workshop of hers, trying to do her father proud. But I can't remember the last time she visited the old sod's grave. Very well. I'll suggest it.
When it comes to boyish charm, Goops has an indomitable rival in Gab. One is the sweet little babe in arms to be cooed over. The other, the naughty little boy who'd pull on my pigtails.
Soon. All right, Clive? What do you want?
I'm going to visit Sid, and I thought you might like to come with me.
Sorry, I'm too busy for all that right now. I've got to get this thermal displacement stack sorted.
Thermal...
displacement stack. Here.
And this is for...
Only the fastest, finest ship the world has ever seen. The Enterprise. Me and my dad designed it together. Where other vessels rely on the fickle winds to drive them through the water, ours is fitted with mithril engines. And those things have got more push than a behemoth in a bad mood, and more heat than all the hells put together. Which is where the stat comes in. I may have already talked some tight-lipped shipwrights into putting the hull together for me in a little dockyard in Canver. But the stack's a bit more involved, so I'm building it here. Thing is, it's so involved that I'm running behind and it's starting to hold things up over at the shipyard. I'll come and see my dad, though, when I'm done. Whenever that is.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Good old Clive. I were hoping you'd say that. First things first, I need some parts mech-in. The stack will be made up of three major components. There's the plating, here, that channels hot vapors away from the engine. The helm over the top, that disperses all that heat into the air. And the shielding around the sides, that stops the rest of the ship from going up in flames.
A full suit of armor, then. Probably best to take it one piece at a time.
Then you'll need to start with the plating. Everything else fits onto it. I've got the designs and the list of materials here. Show these to Blackthorn. He'll know what to do.
Well, I can't make head nor tail of them.
Luckily, you don't need to.
Seen troops amassing.
Blackthorn, can I ask a favor?
Hell with it.
It's for Mid.
This my last chance to say I'm otherwise engaged. I'd spare myself for your sake. Go on then. What is it this time?
She said you would know. Here.
Krieger's Teats. Well, I don't know what the hell you'd want this for, but I can make it. Won't be easy though. And I'll need help. Get Gavin Otto in here, will you?
All right.
So Mid's roped us all in here again, has she? Typical. Still, if that's what it takes to get her to visit Sid's grave, I'll do what I can.
And, what is it we need to do, exactly?
Take a look at this. It's this plating. The usual sword-grade steel won't work. We need something that can get very hot, very fast, and still keep its shape. That means an alloy. Something that won't break or buckle at the temperature she's talking about. Which is where you lot come in. I need materials, and I've got my work cut out already. You'll have to fetch them. Now, there's a special kind of sand I'm after that you can only find out in the Valkroy. Stardust, they call it. As for the rest of the stuff, my usual supply should have it in stock. It just needs buying and bringing back here.
Well, we'll get it done quicker if we split up. One of us should probably give you an hand collecting the sand.
And the other can go and get the rest from this supplier.
Right then.
Well, make your minds up who's going where, we can get this over with. Going after the Stardust, then, are you? Which one of these two lucky souls is going with you?
Gav, you're with me.
All right, then. So, Where do we find this stardust stuff?
There's a river that runs through the southern reaches of the Velcroi. It's the black sand that washes up on its banks that you're after.
Southern reaches of the Velcroi, eh? That's down past Dalamil. I'll go and scout the place out. See about hiring us a wagon to bring the stuff back to.
All right. I'll meet you by the river.
While you're off having a paddle, I'll pick up the rest of this stuff from Blackthorn's supplier. Take care.
You too, eh? Don't go letting him fleece ya.
Fleece me? I like to see him try.
In your own time.
Good day to you, Sid.
Clive, your timing is exquisite as always. I have a concern which...
Go on.
There are whisperings afoot, rustlings in the undergrowth, suspicious noises. My people fear it may be no more than a surfeit of nerves, understandable in the current climate, or it may be the prelude to something altogether more dangerous. Given what I hope you'll forgive me calling your nose for trouble, I wondered if you might investigate...
Of course.
Excellent. You might begin by speaking with the good citizens of Lostwing. Listen to their tales, and make what you will of them.
All right. I will.
Hello, Sid.
Right. Let's see what the people of the village have to say. We better find out if this is just nerves, or something we need to take more seriously.
Black Shields took a hiding in the hands of some bear.
Excuse me. Quentin mentioned strange figures having been sighted near the village. Have you seen anything?
Nah, not me, Gov. I heard the rumors, though. I'm here most days, right next to the gate, and I ain't seen nothing out of the ordinary. Don't worry. Any shady characters try and slip into town this way, and I'll soon come running. And shouting, most likely.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
You have a moment? There's talk of suspicious figures in the woods. Have you seen anything out of the ordinary?
No, but I've heard something. Sound of scraping metal, like someone sharpening a sword.
Where was this?
In Lorbert's pass. Was out foraging for herbs when I heard it. Screeching out from between the trees.
Ran back here as quick as my legs would carry me. And I ain't been back since.
I see. I'll look into it. Thank you. Seems Lorbert's pass is our best bet, then. What do you say, Torgal? Shall we go and investigate? Shields. Here. What the hell are you doing here?
What is it to you?
Not that we give a damn.
All that matters to us is that you don't leave here alive.
Nice try. This one. Get him. Thank you.
Sick of it. Get him. This one. Get him. Nice try. This one.
Stay down.
Get him.
Why were they here? Are they planning an attack on Lost Wing? I need to warn Quentin.
After it.
I found some black shields hiding near Lorbert's park.
Black shields. Though they serve another master. And it would appear.
Damn it all.
And bite.
I'm sorry. Who did the.
The four.
And what?
And I. And so. I. Am. So I. I. But the. With. And I. And of course. I. We. What. Quinn. My friends and comrades.
To change his mind.
take a sniff, good sir.
In drugs.
Gone, just like that. And without so much as a by your leave.
What's the matter?
It's my apprentice. He up and vanished while my back was turned. I'd go and look for him myself, but I've got a bakery to run. A bakery that's now short one pair of hands. Loath though I am to rely on the kindness of strangers, I'm at a loss. Please.
I'll see what I can do.
I wouldn't be surprised if he was off somewhere mooning at Drake's Fang. He used to work there, you see. Poor fool.
All right. Straight home now.
My blade yet hungers. Come. Let us feast on your flesh.
Your feasting days are over.
There's a...
You like a twig!
Those who kill for sport deserve no better. Excuse me.
What do you want?
The baker sent me to find you.
I am a sorry, selfish sod, aren't I? Certainly not a baker. Master must rue the day he took me in. Time was the sight of the fang used to calm my nerves. But now look at her.
I take it you miss the Mother Crystal.
I hated her, but she was all I knew. Worked her mines for years. I had to trade my pickaxe for a rolling pin, but I'm no good at baking. Every loaf I touch collapses. She was the only thing that could fill the hole inside me. Oh, I loved her. But now she's gone. She's never coming back. What am I supposed to do? I ask her, how does a shell of a man learn to live again?
Perhaps you could express yourself in your work. if you miss the Fang.
Recapture it? You know, you might just... I have to get...
Wait. Suppose you won't be needing an escort.
Take a sniff, good sir.
There you are. Though I worry you,
Master. Just that steep, true. And look, Master.
I don't know how you did it. Now, Dusan, I know you're keen, but do you have to use the good salt?
Oh, where's your mother?
Made from the stoutest stoneware. Won't you?
Won't you come and play, handsome?
1,000 gil for a measly bunch of...
This river runs all the way to the southern seas.
Dusan, I know you.
The finest fabrics! Fresh from
the. Looks like I found the river. Now, where's Gav? Gav.
Better late than never. I've had a quick scout about. Don't know what Blackthorn's planning to do with it, though. I asked over in Dalamil, and they seem to think it was worthless. But if Stardust is what Blackthorn wants, Stardust is what he'll get. There's plenty of the stuff.
Then let's get bagging, shall we?
We shall.
Come on.
Thank you.
That should be enough for now. Let's see how Gav's getting on.
You finished?
Oh. Enough.
That might even be enough for all Blackthorn. Here, before we go, do you mind if we have a chat? Feels like ages since we had the chance to talk. You know, man-to-man like.
It does, doesn't it?
Back when you first took Cid's name, we were talking all the time. Working out what to do in that.
There was a lot to work out.
And there still is. Those shoulders of yours starting to feel the strain. Hardly ever see you around the hideaway nowadays. Always on some errand or other. You can take a day off, you know.
Says the man who spends most of his time behind enemy lines.
Only because you keep sending me there.
I know I can count on you, Gav.
Likewise. So you keep sending me wherever you need to, and I'll keep going. Safe in the knowledge that I have a home to come back to. Thanks to you. Right. That's enough soppy shite for one day. We'd better get this lot back to Blackthorn before...
You go on ahead. And try to get some rest one.
Oh, I plan to. But after Blackthorn gets what he needs, of course...
Right. Ready to go home, boy? Let's hope this is all Blackthorn needs.
Is it business or pleasure?
You're rubbing me blind, you know. You'll not find a better price than that. It is better I'll be here. Finished, are you?
There was a time this path was guarded day and night by Lord Kupka's men.
And now they've gone. Back to the fight. Leaving us lesser mortals at the mercy of whatever bloodthirsty beasts they say nested beyond.
to fight.
Attack! Vocal!
Too slow.
Go!
Get over here!
Straight home now.
Over here! Come on. Be safe. This must have been a fishing village before everyone left.
Yeah.
Protor! Get him!
Stay down!
This one!
Straight home now.
Get him!
You deserve a rest.
Right.
I can walk from here. Time to fight.
This one.
Good girl. All right. Come on.
Faster!
Ready, girl? Run like the wind. Straight home now.
Blackthorn, got everything you need?
Yeah. Cheers for the Stardust.
We should go out on maneuvers together more often. Or beat sneaking around on your tud all the time.
I'll make a start on putting this thermal plating together then. It'll take some time, mind.
Thank you, Blackthorn. I'll let Mid know construction's underway.
Suppose we'd better be getting back to work too.
Give us a shout if you need anything.
Started reading books that don't have any.
I think Mid might need some.
If I don't come up with something soon.
You'll be pleased to hear that Blackthorn started work on the plating.
Excellent. One down.
So?
The helm, of course. For this, we'll be repurposing fallen scrap.
Salvage from the ruins? I thought that material was all but impossible to work.
Ah, but we don't have to.
I'm sorry.
Just so happens there's one particular ruin that's broken into exactly the right shape and size pieces for what we need. What's the name back there? I'll give you all details.
What's the name? Right.
Oh, Sid, is this about the helm?
Yes. Mid said I should speak.
I'll show you the plans, then. Here you see the Mithril engine, in which Mithril is burned to generate heat. That heat is then harnessed to produce... Excess heat is dealt with by means of the thermal displacement stack, which disperse... Now, were we to rely on thermal plating alone to achieve this effect, the rate of excess heat buildup would... In other words... The reactor would overheat and eventually this is where the helm... Our experiments... And not only that. Why?
You can stop there. Mid, where would I find...
Ah, yes. The thing... It's no longer...
I see. Then I suppose I'd better deal with this unwanted... Would that help?
Oh, very much. I'll gather my team and head there right...